Hi, Fenric here. And as I obviously played this, I'm just doing some audio check and stuff like that. And throughout the playthrough, you see me looking around as if I'm lost. And when I was playing the game, on my TV screen, pitch black, I couldn't see anything. So I had to rely on the preview screen when I was recording. And pretty much about it. That's once I cleared out some spit area, some confusion rather. And I'm doing no commentary, not because this game is good or something, mostly because I didn't really care for this game. I thought it would be better. I mean, the story is interesting. I wouldn't say good enough for another playthrough. So anyway, guys, enjoy Gone Home. I'm pretty sure people will enjoy it more than I did. But definitely, you know, watch the video. If you like what you see, give it a like. Sub to the channel. Comment what you like, what you didn't like about it. And I hope to see you guys in the next video. Enjoy.
Hi, Mom. So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
Oh my god. You are so lucky you finished high school before we moved into this house. So, it's the first day of school, and there I am, introducing myself to the class. And I say that I just moved into the house on Arbor Hill. All of a sudden, every kid in the room turns and just stares like I suddenly transformed into a mutant. I just stood there, wishing pretty hard for a rewind button. Because now maybe nobody knows my name, but they all know who I am. The Psycho House Girl. Great. So you know what they say about the best laid plans of mice and men? Yeah, turns out it applies to Street Fighter too. At least I worked up the courage to walk into the 7-Eleven and ask for a turn, but all that practice at home did not exactly translate in the wild. So after I was finished getting my butt kicked, I followed them outside while they smoked. And that was when she asked me if I was that psycho house girl. But then she said she's always really wanted to see the Psycho House. Her name is Lonnie. She's coming over tomorrow.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties: Austin County, Boone County, Dawn County, Takelma County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations. This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties: Austin County.
You know that feeling where the first moment you see someone, it's like they have a big gold star around them, and you have to get to know them? Well, there's this girl. I think she's a senior. She's usually dressed kind of punk, but sometimes I see her in this, like, army uniform. She's always drawing in this notebook, looking so intense. I had no idea how I would ever, like, have an excuse to talk to her. Till I noticed she and her friends hang out and play Street Fighter at the 7-Eleven every day after school.
Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected in the area. Thank you.
so cool. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, we're so cool, cool. We're so cool. Yeah, yeah. Fuck you, too. Cool, schmoor. Somehow I always knew that someday we'd be through. Now that it's happened, I just can't believe it's true. I've done the best I could to keep from feeling blue. Can't get you off my mind. What am I gonna
do? Voodoo, mildew, and chandu.
Why, Daddy, I didn't know you were here.
I'm right here looking at you, honey. If it ain't me, it's my shadow.
You think I sent you far away?
I ain't been nowhere.
From me, I thought you'd stay away from me.
Try to cut.
But hopefully you got me now. You left your voodoo all around.
I left my trunk in town.
I got a need for you.
Yes.
Thought I'd hear the grave for you.
I hear you.
My heart a grave for you. Uh-huh. Your kisses keep on haunting me. Their memory won't let me be.
Yes.
I got a need for you.
I wish you had a weed for me.
Oh, tell me why. Why must I think about you? Oh, Daddy, tell me why. Can I live without you? God, I need money, huh? Oh, no one else would do for me. And nothing else would do for me. You've got me craving night and day. Come back and take these blues away.
I'm gonna take your pay away.
Then play me some trumpet in your original beat.
Thank you.
Lonnie brought her hair dye over today. She said, I need to fix these roots. Think you could help? Dyeing hair is weirdly intimate. I don't know if I've touched someone else's scalp before. That's pretty intimate, right? It felt intimate. We looked into the mirror together after, and I expected her to say something about how it looked crappy, or good, or whatever. But that's when she said, you're so beautiful. And she was looking at me. Right in that moment, I wanted to say something, but I waited, and the moment was gone. Lonnie came over today, but everything was different. She was sitting at my desk chair, and she wouldn't look at me. Finally, I asked her what was going on. She said she felt like she'd done something wrong that night in the city. Like I must think... But I said no, there was nothing wrong. I just wanted to say... But I couldn't find the words. I felt like I was gonna cry, but I wasn't sad. She got up and sat next to me on the bed. I looked at her. Lonnie, do you think you could ever... And that's when she kissed me. It's different now. I mean, we still hang out all the time like before. But now when no one else is around... Well, you know, So you could say we're dating. But it's secret. Secret dating? I don't know. I mean, I guess that's the real difference. Now when we get off the phone or go home for the night, where it's just quiet and we're alone, we say I love you. Todd's band lost their singer. Todd said he sucked. Lonnie said he got sick of Todd's shit, and he was complaining about needing a new singer. So Lonnie was like, I can sing. And they were all kind of like, you can? And she was like, probably. But she's been rehearsing with them for like a week now, and I finally got to see them play in Todd's basement today. And she's actually really amazing. I feel so when she's on stage. It's incredible being in awe of someone you love. So everybody knows it's like a temporary situation till she ships out in June. But till then, I'm gonna be at every single show.
Thank you.
agreed our last night together would be our happiest ever. And we'd forget tomorrow was going to come at all. It worked for a while. We had a good time seeing Oscar off. Then ran up to the attic to look through our photos. To find one for Lonnie to take with her. And looking at them, I realized they were all in the past. And there wouldn't be any more. I didn't know what I was going to do. And I cried. And she held me. She said she knew it was hard, but life would move on. I said I didn't want my life to keep moving without her. That's when she cried too. I was so exhausted. I must have fallen asleep like that, in her arms. In the morning, I woke up, and I was finally alone. The sunset light in this house is the saddest thing I've ever seen. I just want to sleep. When I'm in the attic, it almost feels like Lonnie could still be here. She's just downstairs. I'm just waiting to hear her pull down the hatch and come running up. Maybe I'll go up to the attic and wait. Oh my God. Katie, I fell asleep in the attic, in Lonnie and my old spot, and I missed the first two calls. I just barely caught the third one before the machine got it. And it was Lonnie, on a payphone. She'd been on the bus to Basic, and she said she couldn't think of anything but me and us, and that she couldn't go through with it. With the army and being a part and all of it. And so she got off the bus in Salem. She said, Sam, I want you to pack up everything you can and get in your car and come find me. And let's just drive until we find somewhere for us. And she asked me if I could do that. And I said, yes. Yes. Katie, I'm so sorry that I can't be there to see you in person, that I can't tell you all this myself. But I hope as you read this journal and you think back, that you'll understand why I had to do what I did. And that you won't be sad, and you won't hate me, and you'll just know that I am where I need to be. I love you so much, Katie. I'll see you again. Someday. Love, Sam.
Thank you. This fruit juice is delicious. This is some pretty good fruit juice.